Heard it, it made me feel really good. So that's gonna be the song. If you see me on the train this week and head is bobbing and got a slight smile on my face, it's that. That's what I'm listening to. So, but last week was a rocky week for me. I mean, it was a plus and minus, and the minus was I started the week off making a whole slew of mistakes at my job and kind of put things in a shaky ground for a minute. But, you know, I say this, I ended the week on a good note and got it. But good note is we chose our first black president of the United States. So that was exciting to see, and I don't know, it didn't really hit me the night it happened, but you know, I was on the train, I was reading the newspaper, and it just hit me, and my eyes kind of got watery as to, you know, what it meant. I mean, true enough, you know, politician is a politician, but it's more than that. He is for the United States and for the world over a representation of hope. And I don't know, since I've been here in New York City, you know, it's just kind of been frustrating and rocky. But I was on the phone with my best friend Dawn, but we call her Nikki, that's her middle name and everything. But I was on the phone with her, I was feeling really crappy, you know, and she just started rambling on about how her kids, she has three kids, two sons and a daughter, and how they were, you know, always asking questions about Mr. Tarris and what is Mr. Tarris doing. You know, and she was telling me how her little boys come up to her and be like, Mama, tell us the story about how you met Mr. Tarris again, you know. And I thought that was kind of cute, because they little kids, and I'm surprised they even remember me, because I haven't seen those kids in years. But I don't know, I didn't realize how people are really watching you and paying attention to what you're doing and rooting for you. So, you know, it's kind of cool that there are people out there that are rooting for me, wanting to see me do well in this industry. And I don't know, my best friend, she was like, Tarris, you are from the hood in South Memphis, and you are in New York City shooting fashion models. Would you ever think, you know? So I don't know, it's kind of exciting. But the thing that I told her was that nobody ever told me that I couldn't do it. You know, I've always been surrounded by a family that never put their expectations of what they wanted from me onto me. They just kind of let me roll through life doing what I do. So, and whatever it was I decided I wanted to do, they were supportive. You know, when I decided I wanted to do photography, and my grandpa bought me a camera, and they kind of stood out of the way of that. They helped me convert my room into a studio, and I don't know, it's just cool. And I've been here, I feel good about being here, I'm glad I'm here, and I made a whole lot of mistakes along the way, and I've learned from them. You know, mistakes at my job, mistakes with the photography, and I don't have any regrets. I mean, sometimes I kind of think that if I went back and did things over, that I would do such and such differently. I would deal with the agencies a little different or whatever, but I don't know. All of the way I've done things is kind of true to me, and I feel real good that I've never had to lie to kick it, you know, pretending to be something that I'm not. I've always approach things in a real me mentality. Even doing this blog, I didn't want to perceive, you know, give off the perception, you know, that the industry feels like, you know, you should have. It's built off perception, but I just wanted to be myself. You know, I have one life, and I don't want to live it in a facade where I'm constantly protecting lies. So, I just want to say to all the people that have been supportive and are in my corner, thank you. And I don't know, I'm going to live life and we're going to see what happens, you know. So, that's my video for the week. I just felt like posting something with just me on it. I haven't done that in a long time. So, to all you people out there, just, you know, keep rooting for me. And see you next time.